I could define the experiment that I'm doing. Can you? A minute of your life you will never get back. Do you think this is not a real question?
Will you repeat the question again, please, Clinton?
No.
Thank you.
Okay, my experiment is to just start speaking. And I was searching for what is my necessity that I want to bring. And yeah, and it's something like searching for how to be with people without, yeah, well, my necessity is how to use my, how to learn to use my gremlin to relate with people consciously with my gremlin really by my side, because the gremlin's the only way that I can start speaking faster than my filters, than my mind. So that's my necessity here.
Not the question that I asked.
I cannot define the experiment that you are doing, Clinton.
And that was not the question that I asked either.
I can define the experiment I'm doing.
That was the question.
Which is that I've been researching more pressure, and suddenly in the space of no words and no words and waiting on the space holder, suddenly I noticed the pressure, and the experiment I was doing was just moving my attention around the space to see if I could navigate to something that's more like the source rather than coming up with something to say. I didn't find it yet.
Begs a question, but let's see if anybody will say anything else.
My experiment is not to disrupt the spaces with words, not to penetrate and disturb them. And with that, I'm finding being with.
Are you missing being with?
Yes. You
don't have enough being with.
I have that story. Yes.
One of the things I said was, you will never get this minute back. And there were several more minutes passing. And you guys are some of the most amazing people that I know on planet Earth for my whole life. And I'm not here to be with you. I'm here to journey with you. And the journeying involves words. because we're stuck on these screens. I do a bunch of little weird movements to get, it doesn't really work. We really need words, and we're in the same space. Words are central. Words are the tools that we use. So what culture are you guys from? I'd like an answer from each of you. Should we put you in alphabetical order so you know when you should talk? Go ahead.
I'm moving from modern culture to archaearchy, and I'm discovering how it is for me to create a culture that it's not modern culture.
I have a question for you. I just had brunch. I just had brunch with you, with Vera and Chloe and myself in an outdoor cafe here in Ericeira in Portugal. And you almost said nothing. So you're from a culture in which you almost say nothing. It's not a fair answer. Freezing up is not a fair answer. My internet connection is unstable.
You're back. It's working now.
Did you guys hear what I said? Did you hear what I said, Sonia?
Until the part that I was with you having brunch and Aunt Chloe and Vera.
And then you said almost nothing in the hour that we were sitting there. And I wonder what was going on if you're from a different culture or on a way to a different culture and you say almost nothing in a group of four geniuses. What's going on?
I'm discovering the mechanism of pressure, and I pressure myself to speak, to do something. And there's also the silence in order to protect myself from making a mistake when I speak.
You make mistakes when you speak? How do you know? How can you tell when you've made a mistake when you speak?
It's the beeps and it's
beeps.
Yes. There's the thought we're running that beeps are wrong.
Whose thought where is it? In what culture is that thought we're from?
Modern culture. It's from the culture of my family.
You're still carrying that?
Yes, I am.
What for? I have a different question. I have a theory that's been developing lately, and some of you might know of it already, but the theory has to do with the necessity for radical freedom. And what that means is a space of time and space after which you have discovered that you spent your entire life as a slave and a prisoner in a capitalist patriarchal empire culture, and you survived, and you step out of it. You step out of that culture into a free space, a space of radical freedom, which if you do not find home in a space of radical freedom, how is it possible for you to relate? But also, how is it possible for you to enter authentic adulthood initiatory processes with dignity or with power and clarity? Because if you carry over the traditions of the capitalist patriarchal empire, where you're a slave in a zombie world, you know, and a prisoner in a zombie world, and you carry over those survival traditions, how do you expect that would possibly allow you to step into authentic adulthood initiatory processes consciously and responsibly? The answer is, it doesn't work. And so I'm interested to ask each of you about when you first began radical freedom, and where are you in that process? And by the way, there's a new website called Radical Freedom for you to check out later on. But could you please report?
Yes, I'll report something that I'm discovering, which is I recently had experiences that somehow freed something up in me, really freed some kind of pressure up in me that even though a part of me is like, oh, it's going to come back, it isn't. It just is not. And it's fantastic. And suddenly I'm looking at a world where I'm not broken. So certain kinds of urgency are gone from what I thought of as my evolutionary journey.
Can you name one or two of those?
Yes, I'm broken is one of them. I've got to get it together. I mean, these sound like voices, but they're more than that. It's like a way of being in my world. Mm-hmm. I can't relate. I have no impulses. This is another. So this has been a huge thing. It's like, if I don't have pressure or something, I also don't have impulses. And I'm having impulses. So it's almost what I've noticed recently is almost like there's these boxes that I wanted so badly for so long, and they're no longer problems. And where I am, where I'm discovering myself is something like, I'm fine now. I don't have to, something like I'm stable now. And I've noticed it in a bunch of spaces. And then I'm reading No Reason. I'm like, is that really what I was working for? Is that really what I was going for, is to be just fine? And I can feel there is a part of me that's like, yes, I don't want to keep going. And it's not my soul that says that. So where I am is a question of how do I go to my edge, really? How do, with this counteracting force of being fine, how do I keep going to my edge and not doing it from a pressure thing, because I've lost enough hope in it that I can't, in a way, can't go back to it.
I have a proposal.
Yes.
Substitute for the phrase, I am fine, I am radically free. Let's see what happens.
I am radically free. And there's stuff I want to do with people. This place is called the Magic Cow Bridge House, but I want to call it, I mean, it's already there. I want to call it infrastructure building for 3 months for an eco village that is a center of archaearchy in North America. I want to do it with Dawe. I'm already doing it. I want to be out on the trails with him, Meredith. I want more people here. And I want to roll. I mean, this is what life feels like. I want to roll on into the next country and meet the next people and keep, like, I feel free enough to go any place. And I feel free enough to be transforming.
Wait. Okay. There's a difference between free enough and radically free.
Can you say more, Clinton?
Devin will.
What? Okay, I'm gonna try. I'm radically free to try. I'm radically free, which means I can try so much. I can just try stuff. And when I'm free enough, I can be stable. I'm like,
wait.
Okay.
No backpedaling, buddy.
I was trying to do a distinction, but I fucked it up.
Okay.
Where was I?
Being radically free.
I am radically free, which means I could go skateboarding today. And I could.
Do you even know if you like skateboarding? See, people who are not
skateboarding.
Okay, but people who are not radically free don't even know if they love skateboarding. They can't tell for sure. Until you're radically free, you don't even know what flavor ice cream you like best. You don't know what your favorite color is. You just don't know that stuff because you've been a fucking zombie prisoner slave until you get to, I survived, okay? I step out of that whole construct or the whole necessity or the entire, it's like stepping off the Titanic into a drone that's heavy enough to fly you, big enough and strong enough to fly you off of that. You just step off the Titanic and the Titanic goes, and you let it like that. Like you've been living on this sinking Titanic and then you're not radically free. You're going down until you step off that thing. And the way to step off it is to step into radical freedom. You are no way prepared to step into authentic adulthood initiatory processes. You have no matrix, I'm talking about mostly your circle of people, your team, your circle of people. They're not ready. They're not ready to do initiations. You can't even say hi. You're not even there enough to say, hello, what are you feeling really, without having it be strategic. So you step off the Titanic, it goes down, you're radically free. You're in charge of the drone. You can do anywhere. You can go anywhere. Okay. And then. You guys, I'm not sure what culture you live in, but just because divine is not saying anything doesn't mean you cannot say anything. I'm not sure what you're waiting for. The time is going by. I've opened three doors to amazing conversations. You're not really going through yet.
My box is freaking out with radically free. I don't sense myself in living in a culture like that, of radically free.
Not. Who gets to decide what culture you live in?
Me.
Why are you picking that culture?
I never looked at a panorama or a landscape and thought, okay, I can go there. I stay here looking there. It's like I'm looking at radically free. It's like I'm looking at the panorama and imagining that I am radically free. I feel fear of entering a world of that being a story.
And what is holding you back?
It's like I've been choosing to.
You really want to know? In. Sonia, do you really want to know?
Yes.
Do you really care? What's holding him back, Luis?
What is holding him back?
Why do you care?
Because I care about him.
Are you trying to rescue him?
No, I'm experimenting on being radically free.
All right. So your radical freedom now. Okay. It's showing up like trying to rescue Luis.
Thank you.
What do you mean, thank you? It's not feedback. It's a fucking question. I don't do feedback. It's a question. Just tell me what you're up to.
I want to know. I want to know what's holding him back.
Well, don't let me stop you then. You're about to let me stop you.
Luis, what's holding you back? from being radically free.
Stories. The story of not having free will, the story of lots of stories, reasons. And putting myself inside of four walls instead of being in nature right now and walking naked anywhere. Or walking, I don't know, barefoot anywhere. My choices. I choose to be here instead of being in nature.
Tanya, what is he saying? Does it make any sense to you?
No.
Well, why aren't you hammering this guy? If you really want to know, you hammer the guy then. These are guys. You have to hammer them.
Luis, you're saying bullshit. And it seems that you don't even know what you really want to do. And what is holding you back to discover what you want to do? What is it that you like? What is it that you want to explore? Do you want to explore? What's holding you back?
Sonia, remember that moment in Fight Club? You know this movie, Fight Club?
I do. And I don't remember the movie.
Okay, I'm going to try to call up a moment where this bar owner comes down to the basement and says, "What are you doing in my bar?" And crazy, bleeding, wild Brad Pitt is yelling at him, begging, "Please, please, let me have this space." You could do that with Luis too.
I feel fear coming up.
But Divine, he can see it. He can see it in you. So you could trust him more than you trust yourself. I have done that a lot in my life. There's people that I've trusted more than myself, and I just follow it, and you know, things open up in me, in the world. You could try it. You just trust Divine, just go for it.
Luis, I feel angry because I see a fire in you that's been hiding behind playing small and covering it up with sadness. And you're not showing up. You're not showing what you really are, what you like, what you want, what you don't want. Mm-hmm. And the moments where you speak up and you bring your clarity into the space, your bullshit gets revealed. And I feel fucking angry because I want more of that in the space. And this is what I'm asking you right now. What is it that you like? What is holding you back?
Luis, how can you stay civil after that?
Yeah.
How the fuck can you stay civil after that?
I don't get it, Luis. I don't get it.
I'm doing what I like.
What I is talking.
There's no why here. I'm doing what my system likes. And Sonia, yes. The anger that I don't bring to the spaces is the first anger is where I make myself small. That's where I mix it with my sadness. And that's where I push up to the next portal.
Okay, and try something different now. Go for something completely different. The last session that I was here with you and Davin, you brought things into the space that I was not aware that you could do that. And where are you hiding that? The sharpness and the questions, use that on yourself.
I don't get to control that. It comes up in the moment.
I don't believe you. I don't believe you. I don't believe you. Otherwise, you would not be on Gremlin Transformation. That's bullshit. You would not be there. You would not be creating spaces with Devon. You would not do that. You would not be holding space for Portugal as a game world for the region. You would not.
I said I don't control it. It's not about control. It's about something that spikes up and I get you to be angry and I just come up into the space.
Go.
I don't get to control it. It just comes up and I just am. It just comes out of me. I don't know where it comes from.
Yeah, but you know where the brakes are. You know where the brakes are.
Yes, I do. I know.
That's what Tanya's talking about.
And that part I know how to use really well to put both feet on the brake and just brake myself so that I don't crash the world.
What's the problem with crashing the world, sir?
I would be destroying the space every time.
What's the problem with destroying the space? So
I don't want to take the spaces for.
What are you in this group for?
To change the world.
To take the space.
Yes, it is to take the space, but not. We are four here.
Luis, that's bullshit. Fucking destroy the space. Destroy the space. Bring yourself into the space with whatever you are.
Every single time. You know, that which is permanent, that which is real, won't burn. Everything else can burn. But if you don't trash the space, all you get is crap.
And bullshit and hiding behind. I hide. I keep hiding until something burns me enough so that I can enter the space and I just shift it onto what it can be. And I keep looking in the space. Okay, that's a good thing. That's a nice thing to go. And I just enter the space. And when I don't have the door, I just create it. It's there all the time. It's here. And it's my emotional healing process. And I'm not leaving this space now. It's an emotional healing process of being afraid of taking too much time in the space and destroying the space. So it's,
if you are radically free, Dawei, what?
How about you keep going, Luis?
If I am radically free, thank you, Dawei. I'm going.
If you were radically free, you would enter spaces burning.
I would be an incendiary. I would be burning the spaces. And
all
that
right. Might
be my gremlin doing, and I'm afraid of
it. No, they would tell you. Gremlin has a purpose. It's not the same. Dawei, do you trust your gremlin?
Yes.
Divine, do you trust your gremlin?
Yes.
Sonia, do you trust your gremlin?
I radically rely on my gremlin.
Luis, what's up with you?
I am afraid
of
my gremlin.
So, like, what's your example?
Last week, I was holding space for a woman, and I let my gremlin speak a single sentence that both destroyed the space and created a whole new space that opened a huge process for her.
And you don't trust that?
It was healing both for her and for me, and I did not even see it coming.
Which eye are you talking about? Like, who cares?
My box cares about that.
Dawei, can you report back on what Devon said before?
Devin said he's radically free. And the massive, whatever world of I'm not okay has died.
Yeah, in the next part.
I don't have it.
That's interesting. How could you possibly? What? He loves skateboarding. Okay, and then the next part. I know I didn't put the recording up yet, so you can't be reviewing the tape. But it's incredible. I mean, I will remember that for the rest of my life, what he said. So there's a reason that he tried to say it to you and you didn't even respond. So I was checking that, what your filter is.
Yeah, he's building infrastructure for archy here with me.
Okay, and then? What are you waiting on? What's slowing you down right now?
I don't have it, whatever he said he was trying to tell me.
Okay, well, you just pulled out two things that you said you didn't have, and now you have them. But he said another thing. Devin, does he do this all the time?
So fucking frequently.
Well, what?
Too much here.
No, not enough. This is radical freedom. We do not have a vocabulary limits. Asshole. So, Devin, does he? So, what about it? Like, who's going to re-engineer Dawe?
I am.
Okay, we're going to hold you down, Dawe. We're going to hold you down right now. Everybody, we're going to hold you down. And Devin's going to start doing surgery. Go ahead.
Okay. Dawe, where are you, man? Where are you? Why? I don't know sometimes where you are at all. When I come to this project, I'm so excited because I have known you for 5 years. And it's like you're fucking gone. You are in your own world so much of the time. So much of the time. And somehow you justify it. And the way you justify it means I can't say something to you and you rely on what I'm saying more than you rely on what you're thinking about how what you're doing is good and important and blah, blah, blah. None of it fucking matters if you are not connected to the people you invited here, the people you brought here. What are you doing? Why are you here? I don't get it. I look at you and I'm trying to figure it out. I'm like, is it so that you can have a project that you did good on and people like you? Is it? I really don't get it. And you go off in your private world with I almost called her Marion. It's no coincidence. It's no coincidence that I almost called her your ex-partner, because that's what you are doing with her. You are an idiot. You are a fucking idiot. You are creating a private fantasy world with her, and she's gonna drown in it. She's gonna drown because you cannot take a stand for a woman that's fucking bigger than you. Bigger than you. And you, right now, your mouth is open just a little bit. It's not getting in. Where is it going? Can you find out where is this going? I'm giving you fucking my friendship right now. This is my commitment to you. And it's not going in. And my commitment has to end somewhere with you. I'm sorry, but it does. You have me for these 2.5 months, and that's it. It's up to you what you do with this friendship.
Hey, Devin,
there
so you
too
made
too many people. Okay.
You made this slice. This is the slice. And you go like this, and then you start re-engineering what's in there. Okay, you know enough about him to just go, this is connected to that. I'm gonna cut this here, I'm gonna move it over there, and we're gonna rewire it, throw this out to start. I'm holding him down.
Hey, Dawe, I'm taking away this. It's a film around you that makes it so you can feel your heart, but other people aren't allowed in. I'm removing that. I'm removing that.
Put it in the black hole or burn it or whatever, you know.
Okay, it's no, yeah, the fire. There's a fire and it's burns in the fire.
Okay. Probably stinks.
It smells like fish.
Sorry, I live in a fishing village and I know what that smells like.
Okay, and
there's a restaurant downstairs and they cook fish sometimes. It goes right in my bedroom window and it stinks like it's freaking burning fish. Okay.
Okay, so I'm installing something.
What? Which
are these there are these circle wires. They go out from your heart. Your heart needs to be connected to other parts of you too.
Do it. Two hands, okay, go in
okay,
there.
I'm connecting your heart down to your center. There's a part of your center that never leaves your physical center, and I'm connecting your heart to that.
Yeah.
And then there are these, I'm putting in little spinny wires. They're blue and they're red.
Yeah.
And they don't stay in your heart. They feel out. So they can fit my heart, but they don't attach. So the moment I'm too far gone, they can move out and they go to another person. And when there's no person, they go to the beavers here. And they go to the land here. And then some part of your, okay. And this all hooks up to parts of your consciousness that they're not yours anymore. You have them, but they're not really yours. They're devoted to being with the world outside of you.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but you don't get those back.
Mm-hmm. Keep going. There's a layer behind that. Go to the next layer down.
Yeah, there's something behind your heart. Mm-hmm. And it looks like a black shell.
Yeah, it's when did he put it there? When did he put it there?
When your dad left.
Yeah.
When your dad left. I don't know what it's been there since then, like some kind of heavy shadow that's kept you as numb as your father was.
Mm.
And I need your help with this one, Dawei.
Yeah.
I need you to grab it too. Will you do that?
Yes.
Okay. So go ahead and reach in and grab it.
No.
Go that way.
Go away.
Go that way.
Yes.
Yeah, that.
Go that way.
Yes, go.
Yeah, all the way.
Yes.
You can do this.
Yeah.
Yes, go it.
So I'm going to let you go so you get it that I'm not holding you down for this part, okay? I'm letting you, yeah, you're doing great, you guys. Keep going and talk to the thing. Oh, wait, like, what is its purpose? Say hello, what do you call it? Steel, what is it? Hello, what?
What's a gray graphite tube.
What's it made? It's made out of graphite. And how much does it weigh?
Very light.
Okay. And what's its purpose? Say, ask it what its purpose is. What's your purpose? So what's your purpose?
The purpose. It's like a energy store. It's an energy sink. It's
what kind of energy? What kind of energy is
connection?
Behind?
Connection energy that's supposed to go out goes through my back and into this like a battery or something.
Yeah. So that what?
It's just storing it there so it doesn't go
now
out.
Now it has a purpose.
To keep it from going out of me.
So that
I can be by myself.
So that. so that it doesn't happen what happened with your dad when he left. So you don't have to feel that with anybody else ever again.
So there can't be another person to abandon me.
Exactly. You've got the thing in your hands. What do you want to do with it?
I want to smash it.
Okay, but it's a useful thing that somebody else could use to save their life. It's not something to be smashed.
Yeah.
Are you done with it?
Yeah, I'm done with it.
Okay, you got to convince Devin because...
Devin, I'm done with it.
You got to convince him. Say more words.
You've paid so
I'm
much.
Done with it, and I'm not done with creating a friendship with you. I'm not done. I'm not done.
So remember those curly wire things that he installed? Blue and the red things?
I'm sending them up these stairs to you, through this ceiling to you.
Are you okay, Dawei, while you're doing that?
Yes, I'm okay.
Okay, then it sounds like you're ready to let that thing go to some other boy or girl somewhere to save their life.
Yes.
Okay, I'm opening, to start letting it go, I'm going to open a hole in the golden cube. You've got to see which direction it's going. Point to the direction, please. Good. Okay. What country is that?
Uzbekistan.
God, a lot of shit's been going to Uzbekistan lately. I have no shit what's going on there, but it's supposed to be bad. You're the third person in a row sending stuff to Uzbekistan. I don't get this. Boy or girl?
Boy.
Thank you. Hole is closed. You're going to need to put some golden balls of your own energy and information in there. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it flows all the way up to you too, Devin.
Yeah. Yeah. Try to put it in and not cough it out your mouth. Let it integrate. Breathe, keep breathing all the way down your feet. Let it fill up that place behind your heart. That way we put a little cream kind of in your heart area around there too, because the surgeries that Devin did with your permission, it kind of, you know, makes these weird connections and stuff, and it just would be helping to put some cream in. Yeah. What color is the cream?
Lavender, purple.
Okay. Good. Let the sounds out. Devin, any other comments about that? Anything else Dawei needs to know?
No.
Are you willing to repeat what you said before that he didn't get?
Yes. Okay. You didn't get that I really love you. You didn't get how much your friendship has meant in my life. And you didn't get that it breaks my heart to be around you right now. Because I miss being in real closeness with you.
And you packaged it in this other thing. Seven.
Packaged it in this other thing.
Can you say that, Dawe?
Yeah, we've been running an experiment. Meg and hear offers to each other, and I didn't even hear it.
Yeah.
One of all of them.
Yeah. Yeah. What's the experiment, Dawe?
The Bridge House is making 1,000 offers of intimacy in 1 week. And we're writing all of them down. I didn't get, Devin, that you were saying you love me. And that breaks your heart to be around me right now. I didn't get this massive offer of love.
It wasn't just love. He was also making a massive offer of high-level fun.
Yeah, high level fun.
Yeah, but do you remember, Devin, what you said?
Just now or?
No, before. When you were first talking to Dawe, there was a whole thing that you all say it.
I want to build an eco-village with you. I want to do an outrageous experiment with you. I want to be by your side. I want to blow wind into your sails. I want to have. I want to go through even finding our way because we're evolving, and it means that we don't get to connect with the same person every day. And I want to find my way. I want to find my way into intimacy with you anew.
Can you talk about
for life, for my life?
Can you talk about rolling that out into the next country or city? Or I don't know what you said. Yeah.
I don't know if you do that together, but it's like wherever I am or wherever you are, maybe we roll around the world together. Maybe not. I don't know why I got a role. I know I got a role, but it doesn't mean that. And it means that I roll with you in my heart and on my phone and in my email and in love letters we send to each other, like on a lot of levels.
Yeah, and just paint the road again. Paint the what it is you're rolling out.
Which, can you give me another hint? I don't know what you're talking.
Just, you were talking about, can somebody else say it? Lewis, can you say it? Or Sonia, go ahead.
Yes, you were talking about creating this space with Dawe, with this infrastructure. and you invited him. You said, I want to do this with you. And then you went into this other space where I'm going to keep on rolling and go to the next space and meet new people and continue on meeting people and go from that space into the next. This is what I got.
And Louis Howard, you said it.
And that about the friendship, it's hanging in this wire. It's really, it's up to you that way to get up the stairs and say it to Devin in its face. It's not really sending it through the wall. And it's not only about creating an eco-village. I heard much more than that. I heard the man that it's side by side with you that way. And you are about to lose that man forever if you don't fucking go up the stairs now. And I don't know if you want to go, but he just told you something about your heart and what you do with women. And that kind of arrows only comes once. You don't get to have a second arrow. And that one, I think it just went through. You just got the wind of it. So maybe you want to ask that to Devin again. What was he saying about that, about you and women?
Thank you, Luis. Devin, you... How am I drowning my partner who's a, what did you say, a bigger woman than me?
You don't delight in her.
I don't delight in her.
You don't delight from her ordinary to her archetypal, you don't delight. And your window of delight is about what you can delight in, which is this big. But she's this big. And somehow you find ways to dismiss it or to piss on it. So that's a huge one.
Can you give one example of one, like a experiment to try in terms of expanding his delight window?
Yes.
His capacity for delight.
Yeah. Okay, yes, when you're with her for an hour or something, 30 minutes, an hour a day, you start noticing what she's noticing. And you might do it just by what she says out loud first, but you can watch where her eyes go. You can hear her complain is another hint, but to just start to get where her attention spreads to, because her attention spreads to such high quality thing. I mean, you could fall in love with that. Get such food from that. And you might even be compelled to give it back to her by saying, how do you... I can't believe you noticed it.
Noticed
this thing. Something like that.
Like, it's so amazing that you noticed this thing, or I'm so inspired that you noticed this thing, or it feeds me that you noticed this thing.
You could notice who feeds the chickens every morning, who closes their coop every night, who's the most concerned that they're not laying eggs, who gave them names, who stands at the window watching the chickens the most, who can't help but be a little bit obsessed. It's wild. And it's the kind of consciousness that spins up pigs and that spins up the garden and that spins up rocks where the people will sit. And that spins up the circle of trees where the witches meet. Like, that's that consciousness.
And this stuff is so delightful. It is incredibly delightful.
I have an experiment too that way.
You can hold on, Sonia, just one second.
Yes.
Those wires that you guys just installed, they're temporary aids right now. They're ways for your heart to open up. Through those wires, they'll fall off by themselves. But those things, that's what will allow you to be delighted. You just follow those little curly wire things, and that your heart will just expand to be able to tolerate the intensity of the light that's surrounding you, like engulfing you, because of the space that you're holding. And it shows up, and then you just shut the window down. You don't have to do that anymore. You have the capacity with these wires to let it get bigger and bigger and bigger, and just be astonished by how big the delight can be. Like, let it fry your circuits, how big your delight is. Good, Sonia, thank you.
Yes, it's when you wake up in the morning before doing anything else, and Meredith wakes up with you, you ask her, who are you today? And you just let her speak. You don't say a word. And you'll notice the tone of her voice, how her lips are moving. How is her skin, her eyes? What is the expression that is coming through her eyes, her eyebrows, her hair? Is she moving her hands? How is she breathing? Does she hold her breath while she's speaking? And you just let it come in. And you do not say a word until she stops talking.
Stops talking, and you wait 30 or 45 seconds, and she still doesn't start talking again. So it isn't that she stops talking for 5 seconds. Wait and breathe and be delighted. You know, let the tears come to your eyes in delight. Let the smile reach to your ears in delight.
Thank you, Sonia. Luis, go.
It's for you, it's for me, that way. It's for you and me. It's so wonderful to have the privilege of awakening with a woman close to us, and just not even looking straight to her, so that the woman can just move on her own rhythm, so that it does not get disturbed by our eye gaze. It's like revering the presence of such a wonder. It's like I will not look at you until I don't get to have the allowance to look at you. It's like, wait, there's this moment, and I'm about to witness it. And that way, you might be losing that. You might be losing the moment where you will find your man. The man that in that moment might get the ecstasy of witnessing feminine. That subtle single moment where the feminine is allowing you to see that it's there, instead of hiding of all the dangerous world that patriarchy created for that woman. And from what I heard, you are losing that. You are losing that moment after moment. And Devin brought that to you. It's not only delight, it's the reason, one of the reasons why you are here as a man. You get to witness sometimes, really rarely, the possibility of witnessing feminine. That's maybe the only thing that will ever nurture you as a man. It's not about only creating and materializing things. It's about not really being able to see that once in your fucking life. And you are letting that go. I heard that there's a woman around you. Then you are not really taking care of that that way. What the fuck are you doing? Can you say that that way?
I feel sad about that.
Because?
It's so precious. I'm hunting for the preciousness in my life, and it's just all around me. Mm. And somehow I am fucking people loving me and this beautiful woman and we're building an eco village and I make it not enough.
In radical freedom, it is enough. Can you find that? In radical freedom, yes. It is enough.
Yes.
You can find that. There's no, yes. There's no comparison. There's no judgment. There's no pressure. The whole thing can fall off. It's not enough. That thing can fall off. According to the script that I'm looking at, it's either Sonia or Devin speaking next.
Sonia.
I'm noticing this delight. And how I'm holding back from being delighted in the spaces that I am. And it just came clearly to that way, the experiment. And I could sense the delight in asking someone the question. And what you said that way, I make it not enough. It lands in me. I'm making the spaces where I am not enough by holding back this delight. And I'm angry because I'm holding back. And it's about the sexual energy and being afraid of the sexual energy and what it brings into the space. And I'm holding it back because I'm afraid. I'm afraid. Of doing something wrong, of being wrong, and the same story all over again. And the delight comes from there. And that's what's alive in me right now.
Lee Lazowick, this spiritual teacher guy that I was hanging out with, said, all energy is sexual energy. All energy is sexual energy. So you don't have to, Sonia, you don't have to differentiate. Don't have to worry about it being sexual energy or not. And because what spins it into White Widow is purpose. Is it for manipulation? Is it for invasion? Is it for control? Is it for power? Is it for taking something. You know, that's White Widow, the spin on it. But delight has no spin on it. So I would encourage you to try the experiment of not naming consistently. That's the third or so time I've heard you say the sexual energy thing was stopping you. And if you just get it, okay, all energy is sexual energy, and just have the delight of it and without trying to twist it into anything that it's not. So you can be delighted by how it is. What about that?
I'll do that experiment. Thank you.
But will you do it now? With us here? I mean, you almost smiled earlier and then you didn't. Something happened. Now, and then you just did. Will you delight with us now, here?
Yes.
We're listening.
It's not so bad, is it? I mean, that was 30 seconds and you survived so far.
No. It's the stories. It's the stories I put into it. And I'm okay.
Okay. Tell us about the delight, Sonia.
Are you something other than okay?
I mean, are you a witch? Are you a witch or a wizard?
That's the question of the moment.
I meant, are you radically free?
I am.
It's more like being in this space of radical freedom rather than being radically free. Because, you know, there's gravity and stuff like that. No, so, but the space of radical freedom is possible. When you said I am, Sonia, to Dawei's question, what did you check? What did you check?
I'm checking that I'm delighting with four men in a meeting, and I'm doing it and I'm okay with it.
I mean, what percentage delight? Up to 100%. What percentage do you think?
15.
15? It's a lot. Not bad. I mean, but these are pretty cool guys. I mean, so 15. Of cool guys is quite a lot. 15 would be about being delighted with cool guys, but there's still some room for improvement. You don't, of course, have to pressure yourself into that.
But you could.
It's an invitation, though.
I'm seeing the list of HPs running through.
Just write them down.
15% with four guys is like 3 or 4% delight per guy.
Yeah, that's right. That's not really fair, is it? I mean, who's going to be delighted about us if not you? I see we have some practice.
I'm writing the HP down.
Yeah, I've been writing it down. God, look, the reason I called this meeting today was so we could talk about being trainers. Any questions? You have 15 minutes.
I need possibilities for the game plan. I've been reading that the website up and down. I've asked for two women to read it with me so that I can have possibilities. And I need more possibilities about finding the game plans. It looks like I'm not touching it, touching the spot with that.
Game plan for what?
For my whole life. For
doesn't what, work like that. Does you don't get a game plan for your whole life. You don't get that. That would be suicide. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Thank you. That's a hint for that.
But you get, you know, it's a child's fantasy that you're going to have a game plan for your whole life. I was talking to a man recently about what should he put at the center of his life. And if you put anything at the center of your life, then it's filled up and your life is over. And so the thing to put at the center of your life could be this question or the power to choose ongoingly what's at the center of your life, moment to moment. Power to choose what's at the center of your life right now. Now that's a cool power because you can move it around then. But the place at the center of your life stays open, stays uncommitted, like free, so you're not imprisoned by it. So when you, it's the same kind of question you're asking about, what kind of game plan can I have for my whole life? A little suspicious. What do you really want? To be
a
safe.
Game plan for yeah, I want a game plan to the trainer path or some fucking idea about that. I want to have the game plan so that I can have somewhere to go or something to do.
So it could be right. You want the right game plan. The approved game plan. The censored game plan. One that's been redacted. The lifeless game plan, the edited game plan. You want to have the safe game plan, the linear game plan. You're going to make Echo barf. You ever seen Echo barf before? The Earth Coincidence Control Office, they all get together, they just barf, and it all comes down the same tube, and it lands on your head and goes like this. It's horrible, and it stinks like burnt fish. It's really bad.
Thank you.
You think that kind of answer works in this space? Thank you. No. Okay, now you can stop talking to me. Thank you. I get it. Thank you.
No, I don't get it. I got it.
That's a better answer. I don't get it.
I really don't.
I don't get it. I mean, that's the truth. Any other questions? 13 minutes.
Yes, I'm practicing on landing distinctions, and I'm noticing that
there's a difference between landing a distinction in space and landing a distinction in a person.
Okay.
What were you going to say?
It is the difference about my speaking and my writing. And okay, I'm experimenting with not saying "and."
How's it going?
You just saw it.
Yeah, you saw it.
And I want experiments to get my speaking more fluid.
I noticed when we went to breakfast this morning that you isolated yourself with Vera and spoke Portuguese, which half the people in our party did not speak. Did you notice that?
Yes.
half of that motivation was from Vera, so she could be exclusive or superior or secret and special, the Vera side. Your side had to do with comfort, because you're more fluid in Portuguese than you are in English. But your work as a global trainer is English. Sure, you'll have Portuguese, but that'll come out all by itself. But the English part is where you need work. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
So don't speak Portuguese then. Keep speaking in English. Tell Vera to go fuck herself. Don't accept the invitation. How's that for an experiment?
I accept the experiment.
We'll see.
Thank you.
Okay, so how do you land distinctions in English in a person? Like, forget the writing for now. I mean, that will happen on its side, but work with the space, work with the people. Is it you're landing it in a person or in a space or in a group of people, which is different?
In a group of people.
Which group?
In the Rage Club that I'm holding space for.
Great. Who's your coach in the space?
I don't have a coach in the space.
Okay, get one. Say, I need you to detect and train me how to land distinctions in this space better. Arrange it with somebody. What happens when you land a distinction in a group of people?
To think two different things, I'm noticing two different things. One is that the distinction lands and people, there's this opening in the space. There's this like breathing in, and then other people start falling asleep.
Those are the two things?
Yes, that I noticed.
All right. Well, if you actually land the distinction in a group of people, their culture changes. Whatever culture they are in changes. The context of the culture will shift. You can feel that. And like you said, I think some people will be delighted and some people will try to protect themselves and go to sleep. But if the people are going to sleep, it's not landing in them as part of the group. So you just divided the group in half. And for me, it's been tempting over the years to divide groups in half and then go with the people who get the distinction and abandon the people who don't. So I've done that a bunch of times. It turns out to be not my favorite experiment these days, because then I've just abandoned a bunch of people and my group gets smaller and smaller of the people who get the distinctions I'm landing in that group. Do you understand that?
The group? Yes.
Okay, so I'm trying to get the group bigger and bigger instead. So what I've been figuring out is, for me, it's necessary to land distinctions part at a time and repeatedly. So I don't just make one distinction and think it's going to land and change the whole culture of the space. But it's landing this part of the distinction, that part of the distinction. It's like preparing the soil to plant the seeds. Like a distinction is a new seed. And it will grow in this, in the attention and the beings of the people in the group. So in order to plant the seed, the soil needs to be prepared. So it needs to have water and nutrients. The stones need to be taken out. The other plants that are, you know, weeds, which are actually other pieces of thoughtware, need to be detected and taken out so that you have open space for the distinction that you're landing in the group to grow. So that's about 20 operations I just said, you know, 20 things to pay attention to when you're landing distinctions in a space. But try going a piece at a time. You know, if one meeting you're able to detect some conflicting thoughtware, you know, and actually consider it together as a group, I notice that you guys are having thoughtware such as, it's possible to be irresponsible. It's possible to be irresponsible. It's possible to be a victim. That's a weed in your soil. And you go, let's talk about this. You know, let's say you live in a universe where it's possible to be a victim. where it's possible to be irresponsible, what would that universe be like? And then you start investigating. And that's why you go down to the roots of the weed, of the thought where of the weed, and you start going, okay, what universe would that be like? Well, then anybody can get away with anything. You know, you can make a promise and not keep it, you know, because the circumstances, you know, because I'm a victim, because I'm not really responsible. You start unfolding what kind of universe that would be. Do you want to actually live in that kind of universe? Well, maybe some people will start getting it. No, they don't really want to live in that kind of, okay, well, that's the kind of thing that will pull the weeds out and prepare a group so that you can plant the other seeds, other possibilities, other distinctions. But the work of deepening the context of the space is preparing the soil to land new distinctions that will actually change the culture. And if you as a trainer are not committed at that level to changing the culture of the people in the space, you know, so that whatever culture they come in with has nothing to stand on. If you're not committed at the level of changing the culture in the space so that the culture people bring in, it goes groundless, then transformation won't happen because they will cling on to whatever parts of their culture can find ground in your space. The purpose of one way to establish a transformational space is to make it groundless for all other cultures. And then it will start revealing, like I said, the weeds, the other thought where that come from the other cultures, and to pull the weeds out to prepare the soil. There's a lot involved in landing a distinction in a group of people. It's very easy to land a distinction in a space. You just call it in like a bright principle, it's in the space. And then people will feel it or be confused, or they'll react, and the space will have this, and it will eventually eject people. The space will eject people who don't like that distinction. People will leave. It will reject or eject people. And so, but you're talking about actually landing a distinction in a group of people who are like a team, for example. If you're trying to have a team and bring people together as a team, it's important to prepare the soil and do the step-by-step, gradually working through these aspects of making it possible for a distinction to land and to completely change the culture in the people in the space, not just the space. Is that useful?
Yes, it is. And I have what you're saying, it helps also with, I feel fear of the watering down of the distinctions and the space holding from when, from now I'm already preparing the women on my rage club to be space holders because mm-hmm. they are into that. And I discovered in Poland while doing the archaic games that there was a watering down of the space holding. And what you're sharing, Clinton, giving it bit by bit and preparing the soil, I think it will help also with this watering down not happening mm-hmm. because it builds roots. And I was with this question also.
You're talking about when we're holding space for the archaic weapons and the archery yes. or the blowgun or the knife throwing, and you would move into a circle of people, and whoever was holding the space that got it from the last space holder was not as clear or powerful as, like, don't hold the slingshot by your eye because if the rubber band breaks, it'll hit, or don't inhale with the blowgun here because the dart will go down your throat, you know, inhale, you know, through your nose, you know, like that. And people would forget that. Is that what you're saying, that kind of thing?
Yes, yeah. Yes. People were not passing down the distinction exactly as they received them.
Yeah.
So it would become thinner and thinner.
Yes.
And at some point, there was no clarity and there was confusion and there were gremlins playing around in the space.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. I think how it would happen in almost any space in terms of if there's no space holder who's fighting for the garden, you know, making the soil and nurturing the new distinctions. If you don't have a gardener, you will just have gremlins and there'll be a toilet. It's a lot like if you don't put a fence around a garden, it just turns into a dog toilet. You know, dogs poop in it, you know, and it's not a garden anymore. It's a dog toilet. So you need to put a fence around it and stand guard, you know, and take care of it. And that's what you're talking about in terms of space holding.
Yes.
Thank you. Anything else right now? Well, thank you for inviting me into your space. I appreciated your company and the presence of your beings. Thank you.
Thank you, Clinton.
Thank you, team, for this space today.
Thank you, team.
Thank you, team.
Thank you, team.
Bye.
Bye-bye.